Yeah, this will be a fun week for me. This will be a good week for me, just to see a bunch of buddies and family that'll be able to come, because as you guys know, this will be the most Northeast game that we go and play. So it's gonna be cool to see everybody, and I have a lot of family there.
In terms of just kind of the offense through the first three games and getting a chance to reflect on the bye week, kind of what did you see in terms of your role and areas you can improve on, and kind of what you'd like to see going forward?
I think just as a whole, it's just execution. We all watched the tape after, and we know that we're this close away from breaking off a couple big plays in all the games so far. So it's just little things right now that we got to focus on. I'm happy the way that we've worked off the bye week. Guys are more motivated than ever, and we're really focusing on those details that make a big difference in the game.
Has it been a little tough, just the kind of inability for guys to find consistency series to series offensively?
I think we just go out every time, and we don't even think about that. We just go out every time and play one play at a time. We don't think about the last play. We don't worry about the next play. We're worrying about the play that we're playing right now, and I think that's the mentality on this team, and I think it'll continue to be that way the rest of the season.
I think it was Jordan who was talking after the Citadel game, and he said, you know, Tyler's in there with his pads on, and he's probably still in there with his pads on. How did you take that loss, and then how did you kind of shift it and move it forward into the bye week to kind of be that leader that, you know, Jordan was talking about?
Yeah, I mean, in a game like that, I mean, heartbreaking at home, your senior year in overtime, to go out like that. They played a heck of a game. I give them a ton of credit. They're a good football team, but moving forward, we knew the mistakes that we made in that game, and we knew what we need to fix, and that's what we did this week. I'm proud of the guys, the way they came out, and everyone's more motivated than ever to get this thing right and turn this thing around.
When you got somebody like Tobias at quarterback and his running ability, when you're out there, do you think, well, hey, I got to hold this block a lot longer? There's a good chance that he's going to be coming up behind me.
Yeah, well, that actually came into effect in the USF game. I was blocking downfield for him. I know Tobias is one of the best athletes that I've ever been around. He'll be running all day, and you wouldn't even know that he'd still be able to be running. I'd get tired myself, to be honest with you, the way he runs sideline to sideline. But, yeah, you know, when a athlete like him has the ball, that you're going to be holding that block for a little longer, because they can make so many people miss. And just getting pieces of guys is enough for those guys to crease things and get extra yards out of them. So having an athlete like him is definitely awesome to have.
In terms of the offense, and do you feel like you're seeing kind of, without getting into much detail, where the corner can be turned, I guess, offensively?
Yeah.
Start to kind of look like what Coach Spadno has in mind?
Yeah, it's just details. Since they've gotten here, we've come a long way. I've seen it since day one of spring ball to where we are now, and we've come a long way. And now it's just about perfecting the details of the plays, knowing everyone's role and how it fits into the play. You know what I mean? Putting all the pieces of the puzzle together. So that's what it's all about, just playing 11 as one, and that's what we're focused on.
Coach Pat was talking, he said a few times, he's like, you know, you go back and you watch the tape and we're one step away,
yeah,
or one,
yeah,
block.
Mm-hmm.
When you see that, what's kind of that missing link? What is that missing piece to kind of get that one step and that one?
Yeah, it's just like I said, it's just the little details that sometimes that aren't getting done correctly. But I think the guys have noticed the issues and are paying more attention and are more motivated to fix those issues that we're having. It's just, like I said, putting the pieces of the puzzle together. 11 is one, and I think the guys have done a great job of really buying into it, and they realize now how important each guy is on every play.
How many people do you have coming,
Sarah? I'll probably have over 20, I would assume. There's people every day that are hitting me up, can you get tickets, can you get tickets? people that I haven't talked to in a while, but it's good to hear from them too, and it's awesome. It's going to be fun to go up there to the Northeast and play some football again in the fall.
Have you been working your teammates over to see who has people might come in?
Yeah. Well, I get lucky here because a lot of the guys are from the South, right? So there's me, Jared, Rich, and Dylan Devaney is the four Northeast guys, right? So All four of us are really excited to go back up there and play in the Northeast. Hopefully have a little fall chill in the air that we haven't experienced down here, right? I missed that during football season, so hopefully we get something like that.
Could be a big day for the tight ends.
Yeah, yeah. I hope so. Yeah, two of us playing Northeast football against, it'll be awesome.
Thanks, Tyler.
All right, awesome. Thank you, guys.
Okay,